Our next subject is education.
And a question I would have for any political candidates who might have some ability to impact legislation is, where do you stand on education? We know that we're lagging behind other industrial nations in terms of producing college graduates, and so we need all the help that we can get.
Somewhat about college education, but mm-hmm. but in general, looking at preschool through college education, right. What can we do?
Education's a topic that's near and dear to my heart. That's really the area that got me involved in public policy and in politics. I was on a school board for 20 years. That's the best place for educational decisions to be made, is by a local school board working with parents, working with educators to truly meet the needs of the students. And I think that local communities can best make those decisions. I would repeal No Child Left Behind. I am not a supporter of No Child Left Behind as a school board member and as a person who has their degree in education. I believe that testing is a snapshot in time. And the way it was set up, I think there were good goals there. They were very admirable, but we're not seeing it carried through. We're not seeing our children's education improve through that piece of legislation. So I would support repealing that. I think the best place for educational policy to take place is at a local level with input from the state.
What about the role of the U.S. Department of Education?
I think it would be limited at best.
Meaning
that the best decisions are made locally. You know, we're here in Nebraska, we are so fortunate. We have great public schools in this state. You know, I've seen it being president of the Nebraska School Board Association and being able to work with fellow board members from all across the state and seeing what all these districts that we have here in Nebraska, the great results that we have with our students. It's a great setup that we have here in Nebraska. We have good private schools. We have good parochial schools. Nebraskans should be proud of the education that our students receive. You know, they do well nationally. We have some districts that could do better with graduation rates, but those are issues that are being addressed locally by those people that are involved.
Is there any way that you believe the federal government can impact the quality of education?
No. I think the federal government can be a proponent for quality education, can help with research and development with education, especially at the post-secondary level. But when we're talking preschool through 12th grade, I think that's best handled locally.
A question somewhat specific to college, but in general, it's a good starting point for a conversation on preschool through college education. How do we improve it?
Well, I mean, we have to, you know, I would say redouble the efforts in early childhood. I mean, the payoff there is huge, and you know, you've got problems if you're out there trying to buy childcare for your child, you can't afford to pay enough to get the quality that you need for that child. So we've got this kind of vicious cycle going on, and there's some wonderful not-for-profit efforts going on, Educare, others that are really. They're taking available research and they're saying we're going to solve the problem. The University of Nebraska just got a big gift to fund a research institute for early childhood. So there's huge payoff here, huge payoff down the road and helping kids be ready when they come into that kindergarten experience. Secondly, I would say, I mean, I happen to be a believer in vocational education. I don't believe that every child should be going to college. And I believe that we've got to make certain that we provide the support and the encouragement in the voc ed space. There's a lot of skilled labor openings out there in the state of Nebraska right now. You can earn a really good living for a family as an electrician, as a plumber, and so forth. And I think we have to make certain that our public infrastructure strategy is sufficient so that there are plenty of jobs out there in that space, because God knows we got plenty of things that we need to build. At the college level, I would say, I think we got to put more money in the equity side, in the Pell Grant side, and less money in the loan side. And I think we have to make certain that when if somebody is enrolling a student, especially in the for-profit sector, that they're not enrolling a student just to get the Title IV, the student loan money, Because, I mean, I've talked to way too many kids in Nebraska that have $100,000, $200,000 worth of debt, and they'll be paying that off for the rest of their lives. So I think you really have to pay attention to the equity side. And last thing I'd say is we got to provide incentives to our colleges and universities and support them when they do it to lower the unit cost, to get higher quality and lower unit costs. And it's hard. Having been a university president, I can tell you that it's hard to do. But we have to provide the support for those university and college presidents when they do that.
Talk a little bit about No Child Left Behind.
Well, I favor swapping out the cost of Medicaid with the feds on education entirely. I think it'd be better if the feds did Medicaid. I think you could make it a non-welfare portable program comparable to Medicare. You pay if you can pay, and I just think you'd be much better off. You could drive it through the insurance exchanges so the states have a lot of control over what gets done, and let the states do K-12. It's not just No Child Left Behind, but it's in other areas as well. The states do education better than the feds. And the founders understood that in 1787 when the Constitution was written. So I think almost everything that I've looked at in the feds, I mean, Title I helps a great deal, special education we haven't funded. There's lots of things that we do, but with No Child Left Behind and I think Race to the Top monies, it's been way too coercive, way too much testing, way too much non-productive activities, and adds to the motivation for me to be an advocate of swapping out the K-12 expenditures with state expenditures right now for Medicaid.
With that in mind, a diminished role for the U.S. Department of Education?
A diminished role for the U.S. Department of Education in K-12, yes.